It's all about the horses. And then again, it's the realness of connections with everybody I work with. There's something about you're with horses and everyone's real. They are who they are. And the horses do it without judgment.
I now have a new direction. And it is with horses. And without that partnering with the horse, I would have never uncovered this for myself.
I really can't wait. So this workshop has just brought so much inspiration and forward momentum and life, brought life to this for me.
I think there are a lot of people who love animals and love horses and truthfully can find themselves disconnected from people because it's easier to trust a horse than it is a human. But I believe our work, my work, this business, and the people that are attracted to come here and study and learn from my horse teachers and my human teachers like Gerhard, with this exquisite horse dream model, come here because they are looking for a way to be a bridge from the best parts of the animal into the human world. I certainly operate a business. I have a retirement home for horses because I believe that these elder horses have given their whole lives to humans. They've taught us to ride, they've been of service, and at the end of their lives, they deserve to live that life out in dignity. And they are the most amazing, seasoned mentors, teachers, guides for us because of all of that life wisdom that can turn around and still be of value, which is not necessarily seen in this culture. The more typical answer is that if you can't ride the horse, they're really of no use to us. Not true. They've only just begun to offer the best parts of themselves.
I feel like they're experiencing a chance to be a horse, a chance to be natural, and a chance to express who they are and who they have been. But over the years, it's either been suppressed or kind of put aside. It's never been lost, though. So I feel like this is an opportunity and an opening for them to open their hearts so that I can open mine.
I think my favorite part of the program was working with like-minded people who love animals and love horses as much as I do. But for me, the most empowering part of the program is the I am diagram and how it really helped me to get to my true self.
When I think about what my favorite part of the week is, I had one thought, and then all these other things came crowding in, and it's hard to pick out what's my favorite part. It was all so rich. And the first thing that came to my mind was this one activity we did called distance and near nearness. That's what it is. And one thing I loved about it was the choice of the horse as well. It wasn't just all left to me to say, hey, this is when you're going to go far away and this is when you're coming near. There's this opportunity for the horse to make a decision based on who you are, whether to come close. But I also had the choice of saying, when is it close enough? How long are we close? When do I need my space? And I think about that as I go forward, and not only in allowing people into my space, but to being sensitive to others and what they need to accomplish in life, and whether I need to give them space. How near do I need to be? Does it really benefit? And so that's one of my favorite. It was the most emotional part. It's the one where you just feel such a deep connection to the horse. You're right there. And that's actually just my favorite. It speaks to me the most as far as an activity. But the other part is working with the team. Working with a team with a horse that you can't really control. It's just responding to everything we do. And seeing what that response is and seeing how we respond to each other and how it brings out the realness of who we are. I think those would be the two of my favorite parts of this week. Each way they were all my favorite part, and one of the most impactful was the team building that we did on the second day, where we walked the horse through a course with no lead line, with no halter, with no head collar, just as a group, finding a spot that we felt connection to, and we moved this horse so gracefully through this pattern that, you know, none of us had known each other before, and it's not like we had a history. It was just a very organic and powerful moment for me.
I believe that leadership exists in relationship to something. It does not exist in a vacuum. You know, and on a personal level, leadership is really about what inspires our heart and our passion for living, for creating, for designing, for dreaming, for our destiny, for our discoveries. On a professional level or organizational level, I believe leadership is really about inspiring others to, you know, unite around excellence. It's like a rainbow over the world. It's just energized my heart and my love of horses. And so that's something that I got from the program. And I really feel like I'm taking a step forward in my life.
I'd like to make a contribution of kindness and compassion in this world and make an impact that doesn't have to be done every single day, but the impact of it can last a lifetime and last in memories and feelings and in the embodiment of what we do here. When I first came here and I had no real idea. I had been working in the horse world as an assistant trainer, and I had a different mindset when I came in. And after this workshop, it's really opened up new doors and new ways of looking at horses and ways of looking at my own horses that has opened me up as well. And it's brought me into this amazing new world that I currently can't get enough of. So.